repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman. She learned not to be deceived by appearances, for true beauty was found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. He tried to apologize, but it was too late.
Shotcast. She's the one, the lucky girl I'm going to marry.
But she's
the most beautiful girl in town.
I know, but
that makes her the best. And don't I deserve the best?
Well, of course you do.
Right from the moment when I met her, saw her, I said she's gorgeous and I fell. Here in town there's only she who is beautiful as me, so I'm making plans to woo and marry Belle.
There he goes, hey, let me dream. What's there?
Thank you.
No, you're not odd, it's true. No family could be saner, except one uncle who, well, maybe let that pass. In all you say or do, you couldn't make it plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore your class.
Paid attention. Drat.
That's not a nightingale, and it's not a mating call. Wolves! Stay back! Back! Stay away from me! Leave me alone! Please! Get away from me! Oh, no! Please! Get away from me! Somebody! Please! Help me! Please! Leave me alone!
I'll be on my way then.
take him away.
No. Please.
Could you imagine? He asked me to You just missed him.
Oh.
Wait a minute. Where did you get that scarf?
This?
In the woods.
Pretty nice, huh?
That belongs to my father.
Yeah? Well, fighters keepers.
LeFou, I want you to think hard and tell me exactly where you found that.
No.
Tell me!
Somewhere in the woods.
Think harder.
Near the crossroads, okay? Ow.
LeFou, something must have happened. You have to take me back.
Oh no, not the woods again.
Take me!
Not on your life!
And I'll find him myself.
Keep quiet, Coop. Just have one bite of this steak. Serve him tea. Sit in the master's chair.
I'm fine to be hospitable. Oh, Cogswell, can you blame me for trying to maintain what is left of our humanity? Look at us. Look at you.
What about me?
Well, you always were insufferable. But now, every day, you become a little bit more inflexible.
Oh.
A little bit more tightly wound. A little bit more picked up.
Please! Spare me this stupid punk.
At least we are not as far gone as some of the others. You saw what happened to Michelle.
Well, she always was too vain about her looks. That's exactly what she's become.
A vanity.
Little drawers, mirror, the works.
And poor Jean-Claude.
Who?
Jean-Claude. You remember. Not too bright, dumb as a...
brick.
The whole wall.
Jean-Claude's a brick wall?
That's him in the kitchen, right behind the stove. Slowly but surely, as every day passes, we will all gradually become things.
But why did we have to get dragged into this whole spell business? It's not as though we threw that poor old beggar woman out on the ear.
But are we not responsible too for having to make the master the way he is?
I suppose so.
Eventually, I will melt away into nothing. I only hope there's something left in me if the master ever manages to break the spell.
Hold on, old man. We've got to hold on!
Is anyone here? Hello? Oh, please. Is anyone here?
It's a girl.
Yes, of course I can see it's a girl.
It's a girl!
Now allow me to do all the talking.
You,
as head of the household, I should do most of the talking.
Shall we?
Oh, well, it's not so hard, that's all.
Mama, Mama, you're not going to believe what I saw.
Yes, Jim?
No, really, it's the thing that everybody's been waiting for.
All right, Jim, what is it?
There's a young lady in the castle.
Bless my soul, wouldn't that be lovely?
But there is, I saw her.
Now, Jim, we're not having making up wild stories. Getting everyone's hopes up for no reason.
Mrs. Puff, did you hear? There is a young lady in the castle.
See? I told ya. And she's real pretty, too.
Well, I don't know about that.
Well, let's go see what all the fuss is about.
Chip, tell me more about this very average-looking girl.
This is it. The girl we have been waiting for. She has come to break the spell.
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Let's not be hasty.
Isn't it wonderful? After all these years, oh, happy, happy day.
Stop that! Stop that!
We should go tell the others, no?
Yes. I mean, no. I mean, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Hello? Is anyone here? Please, I'm looking for my father.
Well, is that you?
Papa? Oh, Papa!
How did you find me?
Oh, no. Your hands are like ice.
Well, you must leave this place.
Who's done this to you?
There's no time to explain. You must go now.
We have to get you out of here. get you out of here. Who's there? I know someone's there. Who are you?
The master of this castle.
Then you're the one who's responsible for this. Release my father at once.
I am the master of this castle, and I do not take orders from anyone. Throw her out.
No, no, and forgive me. Please let him out. Can't you see he's not well?
But he should not have trespassed here.
But he's an old man. He could die.
He came into my home uninvited, and now he's suffering the consequences.
Oh, please, I'll do anything.
Well, there's nothing you can do.
Wait, please, I beg of you.
I said there's nothing you can do.
Take me instead.
No. What did you say?
Take me instead.
Well, you don't know what you're doing.
Would take his place.
If I did, would you let him go?
If you promise to stay here forever.
No.
Forever?
Forever, or he died in the dungeon.
That's not fair. Wait. Come into the light.
Make your choice.
No, listen to me. I'm old. I've lived my life.
me.
Nothing like a nice warm cup of tea to make the world seem a bit brighter.
But you're
Miss Potts, dear. Very pleased to make your acquaintance.
Careful, darling!
Who are you?
I am Madame de la Grande Bouche.
Perhaps you've heard of me.
Sorry.
You see,
they've forgotten all about me.
One can be, and I quote, the toast of Europe, the brightest star to ever grace the stage, but fall under one little spell.
Wait. Oh, this is impossible!
I know it is, but here we are. Well now, what shall we dress you in for dinner? This is nice, but how would you like to borrow one of my gowns? Let's see what I've got in my drawers. All right. Oh, how about? Not that one. Oh, what about this one? Here we are. I wore this the night I performed at the Royal Opera. The king himself was there. Of course, I wouldn't have a prayer fitting into it now. Take it.
That's very kind of you, but I am not going to dinner.
Why, of course you are. You heard what the master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine. I'm sorry. This is just happening so fast.
That was a very brave thing you did, my dear.
We all think so. I'm going to miss my papa so much.
Cheer up, child. I know things may seem bleak right now, but you must despair. We're here to see you through. I hope that we'll be friends, though I don't know you well. If anyone can make the most of living here, then well, it's you.
Biceps to spare.
not a bit of him scraggly or scrawny.
That's right. And every last inch of me's covered with hair.
In a spinning match, nobody spits like Gaston.
I'm especially good at expectorating
toys. 10 points for Gaston.
When I was a lad, I ate 4 dozen eggs every morning to help me get large. Turning since I looked to that loony old man. See, I
No. Would she?
Yes.
Now I get it. Let's go. No.
Why is she being so difficult?
Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come down to dinner.
So you admit you're being a bully?
Me, she was just being stubborn. After all, he did say please.
I think that may be the first time I've ever heard him use that word. You see, she's already starting to have a good influence on him. Oh, there you are, dearie. Glad to see you out and about.
I am Colt, head of the house.
A counselor, the girl, she is gone. I swear, my eyes never left her. Enchanté, mademoiselle.
Mrs. Lumiere. Hey, stop that! Stop that! If there's anything we can do to make your stay more comfortable, anything at all.
I am a little hungry.
Except that.
Cogsworth!
Well, you heard what the master said.
Oh, pish posh. I'm not about to let the poor child go hungry.
Fine! A glass of water and a crust of bread and then Cogsworth!
And supplies, said you. She is no prisoner. She is our guest. We must make her feel welcome here.
Fine. Dinner. But keep it down. If the master finds out, it will be our next.
Of course. Of course. But what is dinner without a little music?
Music! Oh!
Mache, mademoiselle. It is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you here tonight. And now we invite you to be guests. Let us put up a chair as the dining room proudly presents your dinner. Be our guest. Be our guest. But I'll sell this to the test. Tie your napkin round your neck, Charlie, and we provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot or dove, why we only live to serve. Try the place, sir.
It's delicious.
Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, Miss this is fun. And a dinner here is never second best. Go on and phone your man. You take a glance and then you'll be our guest. Be our guest. Be our guest. Be frangoon, cheese souffle, pie and pudding or coffee. We rebel and serve with flair like culinary cavalry. You're alone and who's there? Of the banquet's unprepared. No one's gloomy or complaining while the front was entertaining.
We tell jokes.
I do tricks with my fellow candlesticks.
And it's all in perfect taste that you can bet. Come on and lift your glass. You won your own free pass to be our guest.
If it's less, it's one dining we suggest.
Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest.
Most days, we just ride around the castle. Flappy, fat, and lazy. You worked it in, and whoops the daisy.
Bell, I have something.
and now to the unusual inverted archways, you will see that this is yet another example of the late neoclassic Baroque period. And as I say, if it isn't Baroque, don't fix it. I make myself laugh. Draw your attention out to the flying buttresses above the aviary. You will see the many cages where we kept the birds from...
A dream. If only he weren't there.
Acts like a gentleman. I am nothing but a fool.
And thanks to some quick thinking on my part, the disaster was averted. And that was the last time a stone of that size was ever quarried in this area. Nothing at all of interest in the West Wing.
Oh, so that's the West Wing.
Nice going.
I wonder why he's hiding there.
Hiding? What an idea, hiding.
Then it wouldn't be forbidden, would it?
Perhaps Mademoiselle would care to see something else.
Maybe later.
Perhaps the gardens. Or the library.
You have a library?
With books.
Oh, yes. Scads of books. Mountains of books as well.
Punks with pictures. Punks with words.
More words he would ever read in a lifetime.
My tortured shape. No comfort, no escape. I see but deep within is utter blindness, hopeless. As my dream dies, as the time flies, love the lust. Illusion, helpless, unforgiven, cold and driven to this sad conclusion. All beauty could move me, no goodness improved. I can't love.
should have seen. All the things I could have been. Careless and unthinking, I moved onward. No.
Either. Have you taken a good look at the rose lately?
It's losing petals at an alarming rate.
Not to mention the fact I can hardly bend over at all anymore.
Clearly, it is time for us to give them a little push.
We need to find a nice, romantic way to draw them closer together.
I have just the thing! How about you warm you two up with a nice bowl of soup?
Soup?
Trust me.
Tried once, to no avail. me away from this place. Make me forget.
Forget?
Who I, rather, what I am.
We have something in common, you know?
What's that?
In the town where I come from, people think I'm odd.
You? Odd?
So, I know how it feels to be different. And I know how lonely that can be.
In a shack by the sea, I'll sit back sipping tea. Let my early retirement commence. Far from fools made of wax, I'll get down to brass tacks and relax when I'm human again.
So sweep the dust from the floor. Let's let some light in the room. I can feel, I can tell someone might break to spell any day now.
Shut up the brass on the door.
If it all goes as planned, our time may be at hand any day now. Open the shutters and let some air.
Put these here and put those over there.
Sweep up the years of sadness and tears and throw them away.
Arthur was slain. She stole away to a convent, and no one could ever make her smile again. That's the end.
Beautiful story.
And you'd like it. I'd like to ask you for something.
What's that?
A second chance? Would you have dinner with me tonight?
Dinner? Me? With you? That'd be... I mean... Oh, yes! Yes, of course!
When we're human again, call me human again. When the girl finally sets us all free, she's a human again, we're assuming again. We'll resume our love, our story. We'll be playing again, holidaying again. And we're playing, it's an SAP. There'll be cats on this hall, the steps way too long tall. When we're all happy, we're thanks to him, thanks to her. Only closer and closer. as you please, but he'll leave you in dust. I'll be all that I was on that glorious morn when we're finally born and we're all of us human again.
Tonight is the night. The night you confess your love.
Try to do that.
You must!
You care for the girl, don't you?
More than it.
Then why not tell her?
I can't!
You must!
There will be beautiful music, romantic candlelight, provided by myself. And when the moment is right...
But how will I know when the moment's right?
You'll feel slightly nauseous. No! No.
You're alone because you feel it in here. And you must speak from the heart.
I must speak from the... I can't!
You must!
What are you afraid of?
Nothing.
Master.
I'm afraid she might.
She might what?
Laugh at me.
Somehow, my prince, you must find the courage to take that chance.
Master, look at the rose. There's so little time left.
You can do it, Master. I know you can.
I think he's lost. Oh, I should.
You should go to him.
What?
You should go to him.
But what about?
Not my prisoner again. I haven't been for a long time. Take him with you. That way you can always look back and remember me.
I can never forget you.
Belle. You must go. I'll never see her again.
Well, Master, I must say everything is going just swimmingly. I knew you had it in you.
I let her go.
You what?
How could you do that?
Why?
After all this time, he's finally learned to love.
That's it then. That should break the spell.
It's not enough. She has to love him in return.
And now it's too late.
Come from
Leave me, please. Leon.
Cogsworth! Stop that! Stop that!
The spell is broken.
What?
We're human again!
Stop it! Stop that!
Cogsworth! It's good to see you. Come on, Belle. Let's go find your father.
Who was that young man in the castle?
The prince?
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was. It most certainly was.
You're handsome.
Oh, Annette. You look so much better.
I thought you liked the way I looked before.
I did. It's just... I like you better this way.
So you were lying to me?
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were.
Well, maybe a little.
Lumiere, I like you better this way too.
Oh?
May I say that you look ravishing? I know, my dear. You were wonderful.
Oh, Cogsworth.
Mama, Mama!
Chick! Oh, my boy, my boy!
How did you find me, Mama?
I'm so sleepy.
Oh,
sons, who are both off at universities, and they're just about to graduate, and I've been so blessed with a beautiful woman in my life.
Woo!
We've been married 27 years.